101.
नित्या प्रासा कृते प्राप्तिः
न भवेत् सच्चिदात्मनः
तस्मात् ब्रह्मणि निध्यासे जिज्ञासु श्रेयसे चिरम्।
For a mumokshu who is mukhya adhikari, mukhya adhikari, the one who is uttam adhikari in the sense perfectly endowed with vairagya comprising sadhanadi, sadhana chatushtaya sampatti. For such a person, Vedanta vakya vichara itself leads to aparoksha jnana, and that confers the moksha. Now, a person who may be lacking in terms of shuddhanta karna or still some asakti etc. may be there, means vairagya is not perfect. As a result of it, in spite of Vedanta vakya vichara, there are certain pratibandhakas, some obstruction because of which knowledge is not possible. For such persons, the nididhyasana is being recommended. Atma chintana. Repeatedly, one has to contemplate, meditate on Atma swarupa so that this pratibandhakas can get eliminated. In due course, the vairagya also can get developed. From that standpoint, now he says, without the practice, nityabhyasadhruti, without the practice of nididhyasana, it is not possible to directly cognize Brahma, and therefore one has to take to nididhyasana. If one has to take to nididhyasana, what all things that one has to do? The angas, the parts in the sense, the auxiliaries, which have to be practiced to take to nididhyasana are being enumerated. 15 of them are there. And these names sound familiar with Ashtanga Yoga. But here they are not used in the sense of Ashtanga Yoga. This is not original contribution by Adi Shankaracharya. This is something based on Tejo Bindu Upanishad. Actually, everything is there in the Tejo Bindu Upanishad, except one line here or there, addition, deletion, that may be different thing as such. But entire thing, you know, earlier also it was from many Upanishads. By the by, this also one should be this. Look here. As far as the authorship of Aparokshanubhuti is concerned, everyone agrees that it is by who? Adi Shankaracharya. Vivek Chudamani, some say this way, some say that way. All I told you, this is all outcome of PhD junks during British period. During British period, their guides were who? The Englishmen. They don't have the basis for our Sanatana Dharma culture. Their own orientation, they are based on that, they used to guide, and this guide and student has to get the PhD degree. If persons like Dr. George Thibaut, etc. are the guides, he is the one first to translated Brahma Sutra in the English. If they are the guides, what will happen? Now end of it. But the student has to follow, they have to please the master, otherwise PhD nahi milegi. All were of such varieties only. Otherwise, you see PhDs from Madras University, etc., after like TMP Mahadevan, Balasubramanian, many things. Really, because you know what happened? They have studied under great Sanskrit masters, those who are thorough in the Vedanta under that. Maybe they did PhD in the university, but they have learned separately from this great master. They have got, who have got the basis of the Sanatana Dharma culture. But anyway, so most of these have originated date, authorship, etc. All controversies have originated from these PhDs only. Some Vedantis blindly follow and they say all the same. Why I told all, see, this is a proof as far as there are, say, 108 Upanishads are there. Some even claim that they are all later versions. Those are teaching Vedanta. They are all later versions. Upanishads cannot be later versions. How can they be later versions as such? See, maybe they were, the manuscripts were not available earlier, etc. But this shows, whatever it may be, these Upanishads were verily available before Adi Shankaracharya. Because he has quoted left and right, bodily lifted and kept here. Even Vivek Chudamani also, it is like that only, as they were verily there available even before Adi Shankaracharya. And there is one Upanishad, Muktiko Upanishad. Muktiko Upanishad is a special feature of this age. It enumerates 108 main Upanishads. Upanishadic number presently may be 130 or 140, it has reached that as such. Means, see, scholars have a way of verifying what is authentic Upanishad or not. There is one Upanishad, do you know, Allo Upanishad? Don't think Allah is a borrowed word. You know what is Allah means? Mother. Allah means, Sanskrit word it is. Allah means mother. And Allo Upanishad, it contains, you know, the divine power as mother, like Amba. See, like Parvati, etc. The Prakriti Tattva, the Shakti Tattva, Allo Upanishad. It's also an authentic one. Not that it is somebody said, Akbar must have... Akbar must have given some money to some pandit and asked him to write some. He was encouraging such thing. No? It is not so. It is not so. And it is Swarabandha. Ah, there is Swara for that. There is Swarabandha also there. Allo Upanishad. So look, you can't play fool with these things, etc. You can't just play fool with this. So it is there as such. So that means, now, main of them are 108. Main of them are 108. Then afters are there. Now in this, not only you can find out these names, but also to which Veda it belongs. It has got a specific Shanti mantra also, as per this thing. So that what I said is, this is not cock and bull things, etc. Because, see, just you dismiss such things, etc. Because, do you know what is the reason? It contradicts what they have to say. They conclude something, and anything against that, you say like this, right? Anyway, gullible masses are there to listen. So that is that. No, it gave it. By the by, it is at least before Shankaracharya, they were there as well. Now, what is told here is, so literally from Tejo Bindu Upanishad. First, what are those 15 angas which are necessary to take to Nididhyasana, and are enumerated, and then it says, so one by one, the meaning is given. Generally it is said, Shankaracharya gave a new meaning. Shankaracharya has not given the new meaning, it is there already in the Tejo Bindu Upanishad. Let us see now. First, 102 and 103 enumerate the 15 angas for Nididhyasana. Thereafter, one by one, they will be defined.
Yamo niyamastyagaha.
Yamo niyamastyagaha.
Maunam deshascha kalata.
Maunam deshascha kalata.
Asanam mulabandhascha.
Asanam mulabandhascha.
Deha samyam cha drukstitihi.
Samyam cha drukstitihi.
Prana sanyamanam chaiva.
Prana sanyamanam chaiva.
Pratyaharascha dharana.
Pratyaharascha dharana.
Atmadhyanam samadhischa.
Atmadhyanam samadhischa.
Proktanyangani vaikrama.
Proktanyangani vaikrama.
Yamaha ki niyamaha tyagaha maunam deshascha तथैव प्रत्याहारश्च धारणा आत्मध्यानं समाधिश्च क्रमात् अंगानि वै प्रोक्तानि। यमः हि नियमः त्यागः मौनं देशः च कालता आसनं मूलबन्धः च देहसाम्यं च दुःस्थितिः प्राणसंयमनं चैव प्रत्याहारः च धारणा आत्मध्यानं समाधिः च क्रमात् अंगानि वै प्रोक्तानि।
Simple in enumeration of these 15 angas. Yama, second is Niyama, Tyaga, Mauna, Deshaha, means like Vijana Desha, we say, no? It will be defined. Kalata, Kala, Asana, Mulabandha, Deha Samya, Drikshiti, Prana Sanyamana, Pratyahara, Dharana, Atma Dhyana, Samadhi. These are the Kramat, Angani, Vai Proktani. These are the Angas. This means the auxiliaries, thing to be practiced. Krama, there is Krama. See that first Yama, Niyama, Tyaga, like that. Now if you listen these, you have heard these, many of them you have heard. Where are they from? Ashtanga Yoga. Ashtanga Yoga. They are not the one. Ashtanga Yoga, they are not only Ashtanga Yoga, many other religions also have accepted this, because there are certain basic things also acceptable to all. So it is not to deny them, Madhura, but what he is going to say is, this is specific thing, a sadhana that is required. Let us see one by one. Now what is Yama? These are only enumeration of 15 angas. What is Yama according to Tejo Bindu Upanishad?
सर्वं ब्रह्मेति
विज्ञानात्
इन्द्रियग्रामसंयमः यमोऽयमिति संप्रोक्तः अभ्यसनीयो मुहुर्मुहुः सर्वं ब्रह्म इति विज्ञानात् इन्द्रियग्रामसंयमः एड् भवति अयं यमः इति संप्रोक्तः मुहुर्मुहुः अभ्यसनीयः। अगेन सर्वं ब्रह्म इति विज्ञानात् इन्द्रियग्रामसंयमः एड् भवति अयं यमः इति संप्रोक्तः मुहुर्मुहुः अभ्यसनीयः।
अकॉर्डिंग टू अष्टांग योग, यू नो व्हाट इज यम? अहिंसा, सत्य, आस्तेय, ब्रह्मचर्य, अपरिग्रह, दीज आर कॉल्ड एज द यम। नियम आर अकॉर्डिंग टू देम शौच, संतोष, स्वाध्याय, तप, ईश्वर, प्रणिधान। दैट इज व्हाट अकॉर्डिंग टू अष्टांग योग। नाउ लेट अस सी हियर व्हाट इज यम। सर्वं ब्रह्म इति विज्ञान। बाय दिस विज्ञान, generally vijnana means sakshatkara, direct cognition, but here if direct cognition is there, you need not take to nididhyasana. So therefore here vijnana means ascertainment based on the shastras, that is ascertained, yes, everything is what? Brahma and Brahma alone. Sarvam Brahma iti vijnana. But the question is, how sarvam can be Brahma? What is that sarvam? Everything. Everything from where? where to where? Come on, from where to where? My body to what? Entire thing. What are those entire things? Abrahma. Abrahma bhuna loka. Yes, let us say, but even go beyond, Brahma means Hiranyagarbha. Go beyond Hiranyagarbha. Avyakrata. But Avyakrata is not manifest, unmanifest. Come on, tell me, manifest something first. Akasha. First manifest is what? Akasha. Tasmadva etasmad atmana akasha sambhuta. So akasha, because for Hiranyagarbha to come into existence, panchamahabhutas are necessary. Without panchamahabhutas, Hiranyagarbha cannot come into existence. Who is Hiranyagarbha? Samashti, Sukshma, Sharira, Abhimani, Devata. So Samashti, Sukshma, Sharira must be there or not to have a presiding deity. So therefore, panchamahabhutas must be there. So therefore, from Akasha onwards up to our embodiment. Up to on. So that is, everything is, what is it? Brahma only. How can we accept this? Everything is Brahma. If it is here, why Panchamahabhutas? Why Hiranyagarbha is said? Why our body is stored? Why so many things are there? Why their names, different names and forms are there? Distinct features are there? How everything is Brahma? How do you say so? There is a technical term, Badha Samanadhikaranya. It is just like you are telling the snake is a rope. You are Badha Samanadhikaranya. So it is how, just as you say the snake is the rope. When you say the snake is the rope, no snake can ever be the rope. You discover that superimposed snake to be rope, and then you negate the snake. Like that, that is what is called, like that. A post is mistaken for a thief. Oh, but when you see the post, the Purusha means the thief gets negated. Like that, this is what is called Badha Samanadhikaranya, means in the wake of knowledge, you ascertain the false nature of whatever that is superimposed. So that way, that is Sthanu Purushavat. So like a post being mistaken as a thief or a man. So like this. See, everything is what? Brahma and Brahma. Iti vidyana. By such ascertainment, what should be done? Indriya grama sanyamaha. Indriya grama. Grama means samuha, aggregate, collection. Collection of what? Indriyas. Collection of indriyas. What are those? Sense organs and organs of action. So, the of these, sanyama. See, sanyama has got samyak yama. So, samyak. Very well. Thorough. What is it? Actually, indriya grama sanyamaha means withdrawing the senses from their corresponding sense objects. Vishayebhyaha, that in the vishayebhyaha nivaranam. Nivaranam means withdraw them, ward them off from running after the sense object. But sammyak is true. What is the sammyak? It is not just simply abstaining from the sense enjoyment. It is not simply abstaining from sense indulgence. Then what? Sammyak shows by thorough investigation. So that is, the vishayas are something which are vinashi. They are something vinashi in nature. Other thing, the joy that you get from the sense object is of what nature? Is it permanent, fixed? It is something which is fluctuating. In the Sanskrit it is called Satishayatva. Satishayatva means waxing and waning. More, less, more, less, more, less. Like that it happens. Again, that is Vishayas are destructible, perishable in nature. Joy that you get out of Vishaya is not permanent. Third, again, in due course, they breed sorrows. So seeing the defects, that is what is called as muhuhu, muhuhu, dosha, darshanam. Repeatedly seeing the defects of the Vishaya means Viveka should come in practice. So therefore, that way, Nivaranam, Vishayebhya Nivaranam, withdrawing the Indriyas from the sense object. And that is what is called Indriya Grama Sanyamaha Bhavati. Now you say, how it takes place? By ascertainment that everything is Brahma, the withdrawal of the senses from the sense object take place. How does it take place? Why do we run after the sense object? See, look, is the sense object different from you or same as you? Me, who wants to gain the sense pleasure, is different from the sense object or not? Is there a way of it? You get yourself. Is it possible? Anything either acquiring or getting rid of is something other than me. So therefore, Vishayas are different from me. I want to have them. Why? Because they give me joy. They give me contentment. So now what is discovered? Everything is Brahma. Vishayas really do not have the capacity to give me the happiness. Means everlasting happiness, contentment is not possible. Some joy may be there, that is not disputed as such. So therefore what? So withdrawal. So we say yamaha. Ayam yamaha iti samproktaha. Think of it. This is what is called as yama. This is what is called as this is yamaha iti samproktaha. So this is what is called as yama. So what is it? First, ascertain, may not be direct cognition, everything is Brahma, as a Shruti. See the defective nature of the Vishaya, withdraw the senses from the sense object. Yama, you know what is Yama? Sanyamana, restraining, that is what type of restraining one should have. So, that is it. So see, one can just by force withdraw from sense object. It won't work because the value for sense object is so powerful, it will wait for an opportune moment to, it doesn't work. So therefore what is necessary is Viveka. So Viveka has to be thorough, that leads to Vairagya, then it is possible to withdraw from the sense object. That's why Yama, first it is stored. So this is what the Yama is. And what should be done? Muhuhu, muhuhu, abhyasaniyaha. It should be practiced repeatedly. Why practice repeatedly? Because our values for sense object will not keep quiet. they will go on surfacing as and when they go on surfacing. So what you have to withdraw. It is like, see, why should we take bath every day? At times, once a day also is not sufficient. Why? Because dirt gets gathered. It is like, no, Bombay gutters. Who has to clean them? Municipal corporation, is it not? And when the first monsoon comes, blame goes to whom? Municipal corporation. These fellows don't clean them at all, etc. How much responsive the citizens are there? They dump everything in the the gutters, etc., starting from all renovation, all debris, debris onward. You go to the market, and being a Bombay, India being what it is, summer is a mango season, and along with mango season, grass comes, hay comes, and then what? Dump it. And you expect whom to clean that? Corporation. The hands that make dirty are more than. So like this, so likewise, these values are so deeply rooted, deep rooted in us. So little once a viveka is not sufficient. You get convinced, and afterwards what happens? Again, that earlier pull is that. You know that they say, like straightening the tail of a dog. Like straightening the tail of a dog. Somebody thought, "Che, the beautiful dog, the tail must be straight. It's curly like that." So he brought a tube and put the tail in that. And now he's happy. See how straight it is now. Okay. It was a nice thing to see. Now he thought, 2 days are over. Now it must be straight. And he removed that tube. Again, it is curly as such. So like that, no, that means that training must be, see, that is, there is nothing impossible that cannot be accomplished by training. Even the unruly mind can also be trained, but proper evaluation must be there. One should not get dispelled as such. See, why it is so? Because it is so habituated all along, it takes habits die hard, they say. So therefore one should not get discouraged. But efforts must be kept continuously and consistently. So therefore, abhyasaniyaha muhu muhu, repeat. This is what is yama. Now, niyama.
Sajatiya pravahascha.
This is what is niyama. Sajatiya pravaha. Pravaha is flow. Flow of sajatiya thought. Similar thoughts. Now the question is, similar of what? What type of similar thoughts? Yes, it is like this. Pratyaga bhinna param brahma tadekakara vritti pravaha. Brahma, identical with Atma, so the vritti pravaha, the thought flow must correspond to the nature of Atma identical with Brahma. So that is one way. Or it can be, in our shastras, Atma Swarupa, Brahma Swarupa is defined in many ways. Asangaha. Is asangaha, so that is that. So like that, avikriyaha, like this. Now many words are there. So first, know the import of these words, and then, that means contemplate on that, but not japa, not simply say asangoham, asangoham, avikriyoham, avikriyoham. No, it is not that. Than that, better take name of the Lord. Punya will come. Punya, because see, if you take the name of the Lord, even if you don't know the meaning, it will give the generate the punya, that is the greatness of the name of the Ishwara. So here, Spurana must be there. What Spurana? It is not Shabda Smarana. It is not remembering like japa, the words avikriyaha, asanga, etc. But how the one who has already ascertained in the vichara, atma vichara, and that as a result of that, with the help of this, you try to arrive at Chaitanya Swarupa Atma in contrast to that which is subject to change, that which is connected to other things like that. So it can be Pratyaga Bhinna Param Brahma Tadekakara Vritti. A vritti similar to the Atma Swarupa identical with Brahma. See, vritti similar to Atma Swarupa identical with Brahma means what should happen? First, in the mind, less and less thoughts must be there. Because Atma is vritti rahita. So therefore it should be correspond to that. At least some, like a mocking way. It may not be exactly as such, but little something similar, so that way as such, or take help of like these many words which describe Nirguna Atma, Nirguna Brahma, with the help of that, not japa, but just trying to dwell on the meaning of that with respect to one's own embodiment and swarupa. So that is avikriyaha amiti. So that pravaha, sajatiya pravaha. And it should not be intercepted by vijatiya pravaha. What are vijayati pravaha? Dissimilar thought. Dissimilar thoughts pertaining to what? Anatma swarupa. Pertaining to anatma. So therefore say, so like the deha, etc. Vijatiya means anything other than Atma Brahma is Vijatiya. So thoughts of those should not come. That is what say Vijatiya Tiraskritihi. Now here Tiraskritihi doesn't mean hating. Don't think of it. Tiraskriti means disregarding, be indifferent, disregard. So that means you are just indifferent over that. No hatred here as a hatred is another problem you start now. See, we need not hate anatma. Why should you hate anatma? Say, sarvam brahma already. And if you hate anatma, again you have to get rid of that hatred. Then you have to get rid of hatred. Anything that you hate, do you know what it does? It gives agitation, anguish. So you will create one more thing as such. So like that, no? Like this. Many times with allopathic medicine, you take one medicine and it gives certain side effect, and to remove that side effect, you take another two medicine, and to remove the side effect, two, another five medicine. So like that. So that is how it goes on. Especially, you see, kidney failures. Many are drug induced. At times, they are helpless because something cannot be cured, and they have to give such a drug, and then what? Dialysis is started. Anyway, okay. So that way, no, not that way. Not tiraskritihi. So that is, it is disregarding them. Disregarding them means not thinking of them at all. Not mind is not allowed to get preoccupied in them. So that is vijatiya tiraskritihi. This is niyamaha. Niyama. Fine. What do I get out of this? What do I get? No. He paranandaha. It confers parananda, paramananda. And what is that paramananda? Atma swarupa ananda. if you are able to practice this niyama, yama also niyama, why it can give you paramananda. How it can give you paramananda? By giving you the capacity to appreciate, cognize your swarupa, which itself is paramananda swarupa. Parananda, and this is budhaihi niyamat kriyate. So again, he is there. He, niyamaha, he. You know what is that? He, Upanishad prasiddhi, is well known in the Upanishad. If you are able to entertain sajatiya vritti pravaha and get rid of the vijatiya vritti pravaha, you are sure to directly cognize the paramananda swarupa. So therefore, so this Upanishad prasiddhi, budhaihi niyamat kriyate. Kriyate means practice. This is something which is regularly niyamat, regularly practiced by who? This, the budhaihi. Buddha here means vivekis. By those who are vivekis, they practice this regularly. So that means, what result you get? Highest purushartha. Discovery of paramananda is highest purushartha. So that is what you get. So yama and niyama. And other thing like, you know, what is that? This. See, Ashtanga Yoga speaks of niyama also. They have some relevance. Not that they should be condemned, etc. But this is more effective. Again, they are necessary as a way of life. So they can enable the person to have certain frame of mind. But finally, this must be the niyama. Now, tyaga.
Tyaga prapancha rupasya.
Tyaga prapancha rupasya.
Chidatmatva avalokana.
Chidatmatva avalokana.
Tyago himahatam pujaha.
Tyago himahatam pujaha.
Satyo mokshamayo yataha.
Satyo mokshamayo yataha.
Anvaya. Prapancha rupasya. Chidatmatva avalokanat tyagaha. He tyagaha mahatam pujaha yataha sadhyaha mokshamayaha. Again, prapancha rupasya chidatmatva avalokanat tyagaha. He tyagaha mahatam pujaha yataha satyaha mokshamayaha.
Prapancha rupasya tyagaha. Tyagaha is what? Giving up. Abandoning. What can you abandon? What can you abandon? What can be abandoned? What is available for giving up alone can be abandoned, is it not? The thing that cannot be given up, can you abandon? What is the thing that cannot be abandoned? I, come on, get rid of it. You need not bother about Atma, Brahma, etc. Simply, I, come on, get rid of it. No, 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 Swamiji, I went to Himalayas. 15 years I did tapas and finally got rid of what? I. Who got it? What?
I got it.
Me! So me means what happens? I only, is it not? So that was not that way. So prapanchasya. He says giving up of what? Prapancha. What is prapancha? Jagat. How can we give up? To give up jagat, we should get away from jagat or not? Can we get away from jagat? Because our very embodiment is made up of panchamaha bhutas. How can you get it up? You know that story? It seems, I heard somewhere. One rabbit borrowed 10 naya paisa from Mother Earth. and poor rabbit could not repay. Mother Earth didn't ask, but this rabbit could not face the Mother Earth, and therefore said, "Let me run away, so that I will. I need not, because I can't pay. I need not pay, etc." And started a rabbit. No, they run fast. Started running. Climbed a mountain, and finally sat on a rock. Abba, what? I got rid of what? Just below the feet. Here I am. So where can you go as such? So that way is not possible, because very our constitution of the embodiment is made up of the prapancha, the panchamaha bhutas. Then how can we give up? Yes, there is something possible to give up. Find out the nature of this prapancha. This prapancha is not in reality. It is something which is superimposed on Brahma. So what is reality is only Chaitanya Swarupa Atma Brahma only. See, you mistake a rope for a snake, how can you get rid of the, you give up the snake, how can you do it? By discovering the basis, the rope. Likewise say, how to give up the prapancha? Chidatmatvavalokana. Again, first, prapancha is, how is it available to us? In terms of nama rupa. This nama rupatmaka jagat, you see, has to be discovered, avalokana, chintana, ascertaining, discovering as what? Chidatmatva. It is nothing but principle of Chaitanya and Chaitanya alone. You know the Drigdusha Viveka? Asti bhati priyam rupam nama chetyamsa panchakam adyatrayam brahma rupam jagad rupam tato dvayam. Tato dvayam asti bhati priyam. See, anything and everything in the creation has got five facets. What are those five facets? Asti, is, means existence. Bhati, known, means knowledge principle. Priyam means ananda. Then nama rupa. Adyatrayam asti bhati priya corresponds to sat, existence, chit, knowledge principle, ananda, adi brahma rupam, it is brahma. Jagad rupam tato dvayam, other than these three, the remaining two, nama and rupa, is what? Jagat. So here, get rid of namis. You withdraw your mind from nama rupa jagat, concentrate on what? Sat chit ananda asti bhati priya. So therefore, chidatmatva avalokana, by avalokana, chintana, focusing your mind on the chintana, thinking of chidatma sarupa, prapanchasya tyagaha. That is what the tyaga. Otherwise, we can't give up prapancha at all. Tyaga. So he, again here, so one may say, we have never heard such tyaga. Ishavasyam idam jagat. What is the ishavasyam? Idam jagat is what? Ishavasyam. It's only Ishvara Swarupa, Atma Swarupa, Brahma Swarupa. Really, there is nothing called as prapancha at all. So that way, he, here he, earlier he was what prasiddhi? Upanishad prasiddhi. This he is vidvad anubhava prasiddhi. This is something directly experienced by the jnanis. Vidvad anubhava prasiddhi. This is not some imagination. This is directly experienced by jnanis. So therefore say, he, this tyagaha, or see, tyagaru, tyagaha, mahatam pujyaha. What is tyaga here is nama rupa upeksha. Disregarding the nama rupa of the prapancha and focusing the attention on asti bhati priyam, the chaitanya chidatma swarupa. He said, Mahatam Pujaha. It is something which is highly adorable in the case of who? Adorable to whom? Adorable to the jnanis. Means one may say, we have never heard tyaga. Generally tyaga, what is tyaga? In the Adhyatma Shastra, what tyaga you have heard? At least you have come across. You don't know. Take Varnashrama system. Brahmacharya, Grahastha, Vanaprastha, Sannyasa. What sannyasi does? Some tyaga is there. What tyaga? Karma. Karma tyaga. Again, a grahastha who takes to karma yoga also gives up. What does he give up? Karma phala tyaga. Karma phala tyaga. Again, karma tyaga. Kama tyaga. Giving up of the desires. Are there. They are all relative. They have a specific purpose there. Real tyaga is nothing but giving up of this prapancha. There is in Yoga Vasishtha, there is one chapter of tyaga by kacha. You know what is kacha? Kacha is Brihaspati. You must have heard kacha devayani. It's a big, big drama. Anyway, we are not concerned with that kacha devayani. So kacha is the son of Brihaspati. Son of Brihaspati. So after all study, they went to father. Father, I am not able to make my mind abide in Brahma Swarupa. He said, give up. Don't think father is giving upadesha to son. Not, he said, give up. He went to forest, etc. He gave up all the things, etc. After a year or so, same unruly mind again came to father. Father has kept a tad vijidnyasa tapasa, like bhrugu. Tapasa brahma vijidnyasasva tapo brahmeti. His son comes repeatedly and father has kept a gramophone record. So tapasa brahma, you know. Here again father says, give up. He thought, still something I have not given. He went and he gave up a dress also. He said, digambaraha. Okay, then, once father happened to go to forest, then he met the son. Sonny, how are you? No improvement. No improvement. Then he said, what can be given up? He said, finally he said, give up the mind. give up the mind. Mind is the culprit which projects the prapancha. So long as the mind is there, prapancha is going to the same. If possible, in one of Mahabaleshwar camp, I will take that chapter. It's not a big chapter, a small chapter as such. A very interesting dialogue is there, etc. Of course, not presently. Presently, I will be taking Devarchana Vidhana, Deva Puja. That will continue for some years because 6-7 chapters are there, running into about 300 shlokas or something. Afterwards, you will see. Very interesting, yes, sir. So, because these all give the methods to take to Nididhyasana. Otherwise, not simply Chintana, etc., Nididhyasana. And again, if you dwell on that itself is not that you have to sit with closed eyes. Even dwelling on that itself gives the clue as to appreciate a Spurana. If that Spurana is not there, you know what happens? I told you that. Even in Brahmacharya course, after 6 months, what is the same thing, Atma, Anatma, Atma, Atma, Anatma, 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 same thing is going on. You know what happens? These words are just only smarana only there. They are incapable of giving the spurana. What is fresh? Atma is fresh or stale? Ananda Swarupa. But if we stick only to words and they, if they have failed to deliver the goods because of lack of prepared the mind, only words only are there, then it happens that way. So otherwise, no. If teaching is, one knows how to assimilate the teaching, same thing looks ever fresh. You know, not the words, but what the words are capable of giving in terms of spurana. That is what appreciation of the Swarupa, that is something always new as such. Anyway, now here he says, this tyaga, so not tyaga, those tyagas like karma tyaga, vividisha sannyasa, all those have got relevance, but that is secondary. Real tyaga is what? Giving up of prapancha, which has by saying that it is nothing but chidatma swarupa, that is mahatam pujaha, it is something which is highly adorable to the madhyanis. And why so? Because yataha, because of the reason, sadhyaha mokshamayaha. Sadhyaha mokshamayaha, it gives moksha. Do you know when? Sadhya means instantaneously, then and there only. When? Then and there means when? Anusandhana kale means what? When the chintana takes place. Do you know what is the chintana? Everything is chidatma swarupa. As a result, you give up the prapancha. What is the mind dwell? On what does the mind dwell? Atma swarupa. It is what is? Moksha swarupa. Sadhya means anusandhana kale eva. At the time of contemplation itself, it is moksha mayaha. It gives moksha. Next one. What is the concept of mauna ours, of ours? Mahabaleshwar camp. Only mauna to be observed, that's only a niyama. But no, nobody practices. But otherwise generally what, generally everyone thinks mauna means keep quiet, don't talk. That is there, that is for the beginner it is necessary, because actually, first step in Adhyatma is shut up the mouth. You know what happens? With talking, so much of energy gets wasted. And when you talk, what does the mind do? Can we talk without the mind behind it? So therefore, mind is preoccupied in what way? Talk. And what is required for us for Vedantic pursuit? Mind is necessary to take to this pursuit. And if you go on indulging in the talking, etc., what happens? The mind is not available at all. So therefore, the first beginning also starts with the mauna, but that is afterwards it will be told. What is the relevance of that mauna? Author himself is going to tell us afterward. But actual mauna is, you know what is it? Yasmad vachaha manasa saha aprapya nivartante yat maunam yogibhi gamyam tat buddhaha sarvada bhave. You become that mauna. What mauna? Where speech has no access, no entry board for speech. No entry board for speech along with mind. Because speech alone can't come. What is necessary? Mind is necessary. So that wherein speech along with the mind has no access, you become that. That is mauna. What is it? Yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasasaha. What is it? Atma Brahma. Why? Speech. Again, speech means not simply talking. Speech also means shabda, the words. Words along with the mind has no access to Atma Brahma, in the sense the words and the mind cannot describe what the Atma Brahma is. Why can't they? Modern people think that language can describe anything and everything, which is not correct. Language has got a limited field to operate. Do you know what it can operate? Whatever that is in the purview of jati, guna, kriya and sambandha, there only language can operate. Jati means species, varieties. Guna, characteristic features. Kriya, action. Sambandha, relation. If these four are there, language has got an access to speak about it, describe about it. And jati, guna, kriya, sambandha, for language to express, before that, your mind has to cognize. Without your mind experiencing jati, guna, kriya, sambandha, your speech will not be able to describe. Now come on, tell me, in Atma, which jati, which guna, which kriya, which sambandha are there? Next time you will see. Atma is free from jati, guna, kriya, sambandha. Therefore, language and the mind has no access. So that being the case, so that is what. So one has to know this and withdraw from all other things and focus on that is Atma Swarup. See, you will find more or less this. They speak of one and the same thing. What is it? Atma Chintana. Atma Chintana. But from different angles, from different facets. So that is what is necessary. We'll see that.